करना
पड़ेगा, ओनली देन दे विल बी।
ये तो फुल स्क्रीन नहीं आ रहा मेरा यार।
नहीं फुल स्क्रीन
अभी लाइव ऑन फेसबुक।
या आई नो।
ये तो फुल स्क्रीन नहीं आ रहा है मेरा।
फुल स्क्रीन मतलब व्हाट यू मीन टू से?
यू कैन हियर मी ना?
आई कैन हियर यू, आई कैन हियर यू। यू कैन सी ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट स्क्रीन?
आई कैन नॉट, गैलरी व्यू आ गया। ठीक है, नाउ इट्स फाइन।
Yeah.
Push. Swipe with this.
कैसे क्या हाल चाल जी? सब ठीक है?
All well, all well. Welcome नंदू भैया।
हाँ जी,
how are you? Thank you.
जिनेश भैया, we can start. नंदू भैया, good morning.
Everybody is here, so we are already on Facebook, so we can start now.
Yes, a very good morning to all. I, on behalf of Association of Corporate Advisor and Executive, welcome you all to this webinar session of today, which is titled "The Reality of Reality Post COVID-19." So we have with us today as the guest panelist, Sri Nandu Bilani of Bilani Group, Sri Sanjay Jain of Siddha Group, Sri Apurva Salar Puriya of Salar Puriya Group, Sri Somyo Vardhan Patodia of Signal Group. Friends, let us welcome all our today. Topic has been kept due to this post this COVID lockdown scenario which has arrived in the global and also in India. Friends, today, whether it is really a time to check what is the reality behind the real estate scenario in the country, which would come upon post the COVID or post the lockdown. There, the real estate sector was already threatened with the rise in inventory level and across all the cities of the country. Sentiments, yes, friends, let us admit the hard fact. Sentiments in the real estate sector was already low, and this pandemic is bound to give a great challenge to the industry as such. The future of rentals, friends, amid all this, the grim scenario, I believe that there is always a light at the end of the tunnel, and we Indian are ready to take any challenge. And yes, there cannot be any challenge which is too long that we cannot cross. So with this note, I would like to request Banjara ji to kindly introduce our guest panelist for this session and start the session. Dinesh Bhaiya, over to you.
Thank you, Jitu. Jitendra Loya, President, all participants, and I welcome all the honored guest speakers. We got some prominent names from realty sector in the city today. Let me first introduce one of, of course, we all know them. First one on the panel today is Mr. Nandu Bilani, who is a real estate icon heading Bilani Group, which is a pioneer in real estate development in Kolkata and which started its group activities in 1967. Mr. Nandu Bilani is in a true sense a Kolkatan, having done his schooling from Lamartine for boys and a graduation from St. Xavier's College. He completed, Bilani Group has completed various landmark projects in Kolkata. And Mr. Nandu Bilani is also a member, founder member of Highland Group, which is developing this Kolkata Riverside project, which is one of the largest township projects in Eastern India. Mr. Nandu Bilani is at present president of CREDAI Bengal, and he has been Honorary Council of Seychelles in Kolkata since 2009. So we welcome Mr. Nandu Bilani today.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, sir. The second panelist for the day is Mr. Sanjay Jain, who after completing his commerce graduation from Calcutta University in 1988, joined the family business of jute, iron and steel and cement. His creative nature drove him into realty sector in 1993, giving birth to this Siddha Group, which we all know and has presence in a number of metros like Kolkata, Mumbai, Bangalore, and Jaipur. Sidha Group projects range from studio apartments to duplexes. So under his stewardship of Sanjay Jain, Sidha Group has received a number of awards also, and he's at present Vice President of CREDAI Bengal. Welcome, Sanjay ji. You look very handsome in your t-shirt, sir. Third panelist is Mr. Apurva Salarpuria, who's a chartered accountant by academics, and his career started with KPMG Bangalore. In 2005, he joined the Salarpuria Sattva Group as executive director. This group is one of India's largest real estate groups, having projects throughout the country. It is one of the largest IT park developers, which houses some of the world's top IT companies like Microsoft, Oracle, TCS, and many more. Apurva has created hospitality vertical as well, and he set up Hotel Novotel in Kolkata and also a partner in JW Marriott Kolkata. He serves on various industry organizations as well, and is currently president of EO Kolkata. He's also a keen investor in various startups. Thank you and welcome, Apurva ji.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. You too look handsome, bhai. Ye mat karna ki Sanjay ji ko aapne badhai de diya. Soumya Vardhan Patodia completed his BSc in finance from University of Illinois, USA, and joined Heritage Realty Group, and is now executive director of Signum Group. Signum Group has projects throughout West Bengal and has also received many prestigious awards. It has now reached Hyderabad and forwarded into education sector and established a school in affiliation with STEM Academy USA. Soumya is also associated with various industry organizations and chambers. He is youngest in today's speaking zone. So we have views from a variety of speakers. Welcome, Soumya.
Thank you, uncle. You look handsome as well.
Yeah, oh, thanks. Nandu ji ko maine nahi diya ki hum log we have crossed that age, dear. Nandu ji will not mind, I know. So welcome all of you. You see, what we'll have is we'll have a panel discussion starting from Nandu ji. All four of you will speak various areas, and then we'll have a question answer from our participants either on the chat box, which we myself and Jitu will scroll through, and we have a lot of, see, this is a very worst hit sector, as it is the sector was bleeding prior to this COVID-19 break also. So we like to have a lot of views on what was pre-corona outlook and what is post-corona outlook, how to improve this sector, what is the wish list of the industry, and what the industry wants from the government to take measures, you know, to kickstart, maybe on tax front, on other fronts. What are your ideas on residential versus commercial complexes? There will be a lot of change in lifestyle. Some of them say that we'll all start working from home. Maybe home may we'll have one room as an office. Will the commercial complexes go down? What will be the concept of malls, investment or return on investments? Many medium class investors have put in their money and banking on the return on investments. You know, the investment class consists, when we spread our investments, a percentage of it also goes into realty, banks, gold, mutual funds. So now, will this percentage of investment portfolio and the investors then go down, go up? What should be the rationale? If there is no actual consumption, how can the realty prices go up? And realty, you know, holds a big key, because you can give real impetus to cement, steel, whether the demand will go down in the high segment. Now, we have all these questions, which I'm sure all of you will deliberate. So let us start the panel with Mr. Nandu Bilani, please. Nandu Bia. We start with you, sir.
Good morning, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can. We can.
Good morning to my friends from the world of chartered accountants, and also my real estate friends who are on the panel with me, and also some of them would be watching. The subject today, the reality of realty post-COVID. I think every industry is facing a crisis today because of the change in the scenario worldwide. And this is something I don't think anybody of us has expected that it would happen. The last turmoil that the world saw, major turmoil, was World War II. And most of us today would be born post 1950. So I don't think the world has seen this kind of turmoil. Just this morning, I got a forward that people born in 1900 to 1950, they saw World War I, Spanish flu, the Great Depression, World War I and World War II, and the Great Depression. So I think we are better off if you compare ourselves with them. So we should be more positive and optimist going forward and not a pessimist, I would say. That's my advice to everybody. As the world has never seen what we are seeing today, where economies have shut down worldwide because of the COVID-19. And in 2008, it was slightly different when economies didn't close down, but there was a huge financial crisis and banks collapsed, the funds collapsed. So it was a huge crisis. So according to me, now I think the worlds have developed, the economies have developed a lot since those days. And the turmoil would be short-lived and we should come out of it faster than earlier years because the economies are more robust worldwide. And a lot of countries have taken corrective actions at the right time. India, I'm quite sure, would take the corrective action. And we must laud the Prime Minister for taking the action in advance of shutting down the, putting about lockdown so that this disease doesn't spread. I think that was a good action at the right time, though we are all suffering as far as the economy is concerned. So I would like to say that we should not panic and we should just be more optimist in our view. All businesses are suffering today, not only real estate. If the economies don't grow, every industry would suffer because consumption goes down, investment comes down, jobs are lost. So everybody is in a state of panic today and should be. But I think we should look at it that we are stronger today and it is a globalized economy and we will get out of it faster than what other countries in the earlier times. Now, real estate, as far as real estate is concerned, I think India, 3 to 6 months, we will see a slowdown in sales. I don't think there'll be much of a price correction because as far as Calcutta and Bengal is concerned, the prices are very, very good levels and not very high as some of the other cities. And Calcutta is more end user driven, not so much investor driven. So being end user driven, it should not be a struggle in terms of collapse of prices. That's my view on it. And with this COVID, I think a lot of people are insecure and they are looking at working from home, staying at home. I think people would definitely, after things have settled down, will look at investing at home because it's more of a secure investment. It is a real asset, unlike the stock market or any other financial instrument, which is not the real asset that you're holding. You feel sense of security when you own a home. I think that's very important for real estate industry. And the India story, as far as I know, I think with the dollar going up, a lot of NRIs would find India very lucrative going forward. I think dollars have touched 76 from 60, 65, 70, 76. So this would make foreign investment attractive for them in investing in real estate. And with the down of the oil price, this would also, I think, give a positive to our reserves as import bills will surely come down. And going forward, I think oil is no more a great asset to hold on to since a lot of cars are being converted to electric and your green cars, the green automotive industry is coming in a big way. So all these are pluses for India. So real estate will definitely grow along with all the industries. And I think we should turn around faster than other economies. As you have seen that the GDP fall for India would be up to, I think, 2 or sub 2. And China would be plus, India would be plus, and so would Indonesia be plus. And coming to China, I think a lot of industries from China would look at shifting to India. The foreign collaborators who have set up industries in China would surely want to come to India. So this is also a positive bend for us. So they say that in every turmoil or every mishap, new opportunities come up. I think for India, manufacturing industry will be a big thing for India, which will boost the economy. And if the economy does well, every industry will do well, including real estate. So we cannot isolate real estate from other industries and say real estate has come down. Real estate is directly dependent on the economy. The economy does well, real estate will definitely do well. And I think we all are certain that next year, our growth would be upwards of 7%. More so supported by falling oil prices and manufacturing coming to India. Somebody just recently told me India is the third largest for startups. I think Apurva will give more of a light on this since he is quite involved with startups and he invests quite a bit in startups. So these are all the pluses of India. So we should all think on the positive side and not negative. As India is a very robust economy, it will surely grow. We have the advantage of a high population, which is over 1 billion, second highest in the world. So I think there's nothing more to say when the question answer comes, and more specific information on our segments on residential and on commercial or hotels or malls, our subsequent speakers will give you more specific information, and then we'll answer the questions after that. That's it, Jineshji. I think we're passing.
Thank you, Nanduji. As President Credai, you are very positive, optimistic, and these are the times where we all must be positive and optimistic. That's a good driving thing from hearing from you. You're very correct in when you said that from those people who were existing from 1900 to 1950 have seen two world wars, the Great Depression, and of course the Spanish flu. So, with the present medical setup and all. And one candid confession, of course, was there in your optimism that you are not away from the main industry. The industry goes up, the demand. You're directly linked. I mean, it's direct correlation with the industry and the activities going up. And the startups is a positive thing. India GDP as compared to other countries, projections are good. So all these positive things, we will hear again from you on the question answer thing. Now, can I request Sanjay Jainji to give his views and thoughts, please? Sanjay.
Hi friends, good morning. Thank you, Banjaraji. That comment of yours was not needed for Nandu Bhaiya, and it was a consolation for me. And for Apurva and Soumya, they deserve that comment. So you, as you have right.
Today you really look very handsome.
Friends, when Banjaraji asked me to about this and asked me to speak on this, and for me, when you are speaking to a forum like you, ACAE, where it means speaking means you are giving your opinion or suggestion or advice. So giving your advice when you have experience, a person like Nandu Bilani, who has all experience there, and with Apurva and Soumya, the dynamic young new idea people there. So it was, I was sort of thinking myself as non-fit in this, that a young person like Nandu Bilani is speaking, and there. So basically, and then I'm speaking to a forum where you are advisor. We have been always taking advice from you. So this is what COVID has brought us to, that today maybe speaking to you or giving advice means I'm giving advice to people with whom we have all been taking advice all along our professional life. However, I would like to put this as what I think on this scenario. Today we are at like, now we are in COVID world, and maybe after some time, we don't know by when, but we will be out of this COVID world. So, and I have in last 40 days, I'm not that organized person, but sort of tried to organize myself or the organize this world or the operation business. And then I thought I have divided the post-COVID world like in three phases. The phase one, which actually from yesterday has started as post-COVID world. So where the green zone and all will start. So we are now in phase one of this post-COVID world. I look at it as if you are away from Earth in the somewhere in the universe, and you have to land again in a planet which we do not know whether it will be the same Earth or some Earth or where in some other planet. There is an advantage ki abhi tak all the planets have been researched for thousands and thousands of years, but this post-COVID Earth has never been researched. Nobody could have thought of ki they'll have to study a world like this. So we are really will be arriving on a really new planet. I'm optimistic. I'm not saying that new planet means we are arriving on a difficult platform. So for me, I'm trying to just put up as what I think on it. It is difficult for me to speak on. I'm not a usual speaker. Whenever in Credai also, we have Nandu Bhaiya always there. So there's least chance I used to hear them and learn from them. And so I would like to just bring it as if what I think about this world in near future. So this phase one, which is going to be there, you don't know for how many days, maybe for 30, 60 days, is really a disturbing time, an unknown time. We don't know. I'm sure about one thing, that we cannot get affected with COVID if we keep precautions. Let's be very clear about it. That's what I think. There are two small things, a mask and a sabun haath dhone ka. Then you cannot get affected. Getting affected with COVID will be like you are getting affected with an air when you are traveling by air and you meet up an accident. Around 400 crores, I will say, or 500 crore people travel every year. How many meet up accident? So we are not going to affected. We'll have to keep our precautions have to make people learn. Those who are not aware about it, we'll have to, it will be our responsibility to make them learn about how to save COVID, how to keep precaution of the COVID. I would like to say only this much about the COVID, because all of you have heard a lot of seminar and webinars, and we all know very much about COVID. Coming back, I have heard the good thing. I don't know how many of you have heard. I have heard Sarat Pawar in a webinar. I have heard Fadnavis, the last chief minister, the earlier chief minister of Maharashtra. We have heard the Indian housing minister, government of India, the Sardarji, I forgot his name. And we have heard Aditya Thackeray. Unfortunately, we didn't have opportunity to hear many people from West Bengal. But I think these are the people who will matter and who will have some say in the central government. You will not believe, you must hear that all of them have spoken so positive about real estate that it was a rather surprise for me. I was not expecting that much from them. So this phase one, whenever we come out of it, the phase two, I don't know whether it's going to last for 6 months or 8 months or 4 months, is actually will be our testing time. That is the most difficult time I think we will be facing. But there's a good news. For last few days, we have been observing our office, our people, our team has sold almost 30 flats in this month of April, which is really, I'm still yet to believe myself and my team that we have sold 30 flats, which is almost 40% of our total monthly sale. So the phase two, which I'm talking about, will be going to be a difficult time, but there are hopes like this sale being made by us. Now coming back on where Nandu Bhaiya will speak, and there are a lot of things being asked that we will have to go to government will give us that, and we'll get whatever, we'll get the interest deferment or exemption or various types of benefits. I think it is a difficult time for us, for government, to even give something commercial to us. They have a lot of other commitment. Elections are coming in the state, so state government will have their priority. They'll have to look into from the point of their election year. So that phase two, where we are going to be there for 6 months, how are we going to be helped, or how will we come out of it? There are various things. You will be surprised that we were in touch with the government of West Bengal since last 4 weeks, and e-registration was being discussed. In last 2 weeks, they have given 5 aadmi ka naam unhone diya, finance secretary ne, ki aap inse baat ki jaye, and now e-registration is ready. They are giving a benefit of approximately 20,000 rupees to the extent to our segment of flat buyers, up to 50-60 lakhs. On 60 lakhs, there's a benefit of 20,000 rupees. So during that phase two, I think we will get, our customer will get benefit of window. If we get a benefit of window where there's such exemption on stamp duty or home loan, or if someone buys a flat, I don't think GST, we should ask government for a very long-term relief. Even if we ask them to give a relief for a year or so, even if GST is paid and the customer is asked to for the setback of that GST he's paying in the next 2 years against his taxable, tax payable or something like that, those things will be easier for government to accept or consider. So arriving on whatever I'm saying, we arrive to an expectation or a situation where the demand has to go up. If the demand goes up, we don't look at real estate currently as an investment opportunity. For last 3 years, in real estate have been a very, very negative segment. And I think for that reason, people have kept their decision of buying a home on hold. There is a good number of people, our population is so large, so there's a good number of people who will buy home. They were holding it for last 3 years because it was a negative segment. People were comparing it with share market or with mutual fund or with gold or with negative atmosphere where everyone was talking negative about. And more so government, I think, was more towards cleaning this sector. And of course, that resultantly were negative about this segment. So I think there is a buying which was on hold and which will come immediately in this phase two part, where if we give them a window, then the buyers will take decision. And if sales are there, if there is a demand, if we can do small part of percentage of our usual business, which we used to do before 1st of March or before 21st of March, I think these 6 months, if we come out, then real estate in particular and Indian economy in general has, according to me, very good future. In my lifetime, I remember 2008, where more specifically in Calcutta and India in general, we didn't suffer a lot. In Calcutta, in fact, as a real estate, we didn't suffer. We really came back in 2009 itself, early 2009. Of course, in our segment, in the high-end segment, it was for a longer period of time. We do not have much operations. Apurva will speak on that, but Nandu Bhaiya operate. But we do not have much of business in the high-end segment in Calcutta. But I think the supply in high-end segment is not very high if the atmosphere is going to improve and if this those benefit. One more important thing which you people can take up is that 50C and 43CA, where if the government, if they allow for a year's time, if they say that they allow that these sections will not be applicable for a year's time, then there will be a good demand even in the high-end segment. People who have opportunity to buy in low at a lower price than the market price will come out as a buyer and will buy. So to summarize, I think we are now in phase one, which is going to end very soon. We started hearing about it. We are not going to be affected with corona. Let's be prepared and make people whom we need to make aware. And then we go into phase two, where all these benefit, if we can manage that, then we will come out of the phase two. One more thing, if the demand goes up, then the investor with whom I am not expecting to buy real estate will also come up, because the biggest problem with the investor now is they are not getting exit. So if the demand are there and if the existing investors will get the exit, then investors will also come. That's what I think. Because if the investors will compare real estate with share market or mutual fund or gold and other investment, then this is more, I will say, stable investment now. If they get an exit of what already they have invested, so the demand will get them exit. So to summarize, we are, of course, facing a very difficult time. We are going to land on a new world, a new earth, which I hope will be better. Our habits will change. We will be more efficient. And I see a lot of opportunity in real estate, because real estate will bring in the benefit to other industries in the economy. And this is the time that after 3 years of suffering, this government has to push real estate. And they, in absence of much resources available with the government, they should do it. So it's a good time we are going to see. It is only this small period of time which we have to overcome. You are on
unmute yourself.
Is it okay now? Thank you, Sanjay ji, for all your positive thoughts. Again, coming back from Vice President of CREDAI Bengal. शुरुआत में आपने हम प्रोफेशनल्स का रोल को कुछ अच्छा कहा है तो लेट मी टेल यू वी प्रोफेशनल्स आर अ पार्टनर ऑफ योर ग्रोथ ऑफ कोर्स आप पहले पैसा बनाते हैं फिर हम लोग आते हैं बट वी आर अ पार्टनर इन योर ग्रोथ एंड वी हैव लर्नड वन वे इफ यू हैव टू वॉक फास्ट यू वॉक अलोन बट इफ यू हैव टू वॉक लॉन्ग यू हैव टू वॉक हैंड इन हैंड So we are always there as partners of your growth, and we are very happy to hear all these positive thoughts from you. As regards, you know, this Bengal e-registration also, it's a very positive thing. For your income tax suggestion, you said of 43CA and 50C, we have made a few suggestions to the government, not only 43CA and 50C, even if they can't scrap it, we have said you can increase the difference threshold from 10 to 20%, maybe, you know. We've also said that Section 23 का that notional rent a standard deduction 30 to 50% कर सकते हैं Section 24 में ATIB a time limit 5 to 7 years कर सकते हैं now these are the things which government can do really you know without giving this fiscal benefits and all that ये कर सकते हैं that will give strength to this industry so very well taken we let me tell you we are also doing because unless the industry survives we don't so We are directly correlated. So we have taken up all this and we have, of course, sent all this. Much more than, you know, all this also. And we welcome if any further suggestions I had taken from Nandu Babu when I was sending. So we have done this. And but one thing also you said very correctly, when we have a percentage of portfolio investment in reality, which we all have, unless this is churned, past investment jab tak dilute nahi honge, tab tak naya investment hum kaise karenge? And which, you know, unless the whole industry moves and there is a churning, it is really a difficult question. But anyway, the positivity prevails. It's we are very happy to see that. So let's move on to the next.
Yeah, before you move out from me, from my talk, I will have, assuming that I have been asked to give an advice, I have given advice. So I want your association to also learn from me or follow me in a way that whenever you have been asked to give advice, You should be instant, crisp, and the advice should be free. So this is what I am trying to communicate to your forum. That let's, if it is an advice, and you have, if I am being asked to give advice, please kindly follow me.
Let's move on to the next panelist, Mr. Apurva Salarpuriya.
Good morning, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Apu.
Yeah. Morning. Thank you so much for this opportunity and very kind words, Sanjay ji and Vandara ji. Thank you so much. But, you know, I am just as, you know, I'm looking forward to speaking. I'm actually very, very interested in hearing back from this group, especially given that the two sectors which I have been asked to cover, office and hotel, are even more of derived sectors, depending on the health of other businesses. And all of you as advisors, as consultants work across a much broader array of industries. So I'm here to learn a lot more than share my experiences. But given that, you know, we're talking about real estate specifically, I'm happy to share, you know, my thoughts about the office segment and the hotel segment. And like Sanjay ji very rightly said, it's a period of uncertainty. We will see a lot, many new things come. So instead of trying to make, you know, very prophetic statements, I will try to underline some of the trends which we are beginning to see in both of these. And, it, you know, there will be some variations playing out in different geographies, in different, you know, different cities, etc. So to start with, you know, with office, you know, of course, just like any other segment and any other industry, you know, we are seeing a slowdown. So immediate take up of fresh space, you know, what we used to call hard options of spaces, when, you know, jab koi ek used to take a hard option ki main 6 mahine baad aur 20,000 foot lunga. You know, those hard options are being cancelled. People are not taking them up immediately. Let me also give a little backdrop to this before I go further on office. You know, unlike some of the other segments, the office segment and especially the IT office segment in the country was actually going through a boom period before this COVID hit us. We had slowly started seeing it flatten out as more and more supply was coming in, but we've had a two or three good years, especially in the southern part of the country, and Calcutta also was beginning to join that that party. So we are seeing that slowdown happen in terms of new space being taken up. Work from home is something which all of us have learned as a new phrase. WFH is the new acronym which is being used in the WhatsApp chats. And, the big question is coming to everybody that what happens, does, even industries which were not traditionally working from home, like real estate and construction, are today doing part of our work on from home. So how does this translate? There are all kinds of news about TCS, etc., that does tomorrow 50% of people or 60% people start working from home. My personal take on this is that, of course, even in the past, a lot of industries like IT and consultancy have been working from home in a small segment. It has just not been so publicized. We will see some more of this happen, but will, 70, 80% or 50% of the workforce start moving from home? I don't think so. And there are two, three large reasons for this. One is not every industry supports this kind of working, where purely, work nature, where work is in the nature of mind, like consultancy, is a little more possible. But in manufacturing, in real estate, it is even more difficult. Plus, humans have an inherent need to be in social company. So we do need, if I have to work from home for the entire year, I will go mad. So more and more, I think, we will see some movement towards work from home. But to the extent of it, I think we are probably overestimating at this point because we are in the middle of the crisis. The other thing which is coming as a counter to this is that, today the norm in terms of how much space a company requires in the IT space is between 75 to 100 square foot per person, depending on what part of, whether you're a call center or whether you're a, larger IT company. And because of social distancing, this is changing dramatically. Already when we are talking to our existing clients and, to the consultancies, these numbers will go up. So instead of 75 to 100 per square foot per person, people are going to start looking at upwards of 120 to 140 square foot per person, which means that even some demand which is going away because of work from home or newer demand which is coming is going to be more than compensated. Of course, I must say that, for the next few months, there is unlikely to be a fresh demand, but just like we spoke, after a few months, this new norm of social distancing will mean that for the same number of people, you will want a larger office space. The other thing which is happening, and this is not peculiar to commercial real estate or not even peculiar to real estate as a whole, is that there is a flight to quality. Jab aap aaj stock market mein bhi ja rahe hain, toh aaj aap yehi soch rahe hain ki bhi hum aaj XYZ जिस कम छोटी कंपनी है स्मॉल कैप का शेयर क्यों लें, आज तो ITC सस्ते में मिल रहा है, या आई मच रादर बी सेफ विद एन ITC और अ HDFC एटसेट्रा. एंड द सेम थिंग इज गोइंग टू हैपन इन कमर्शियल स्पेसेस आल्सो, वेयर यू विल सी आई विल गो विद अ ब्रांड व्हिच कैन प्रोवाइड मी नॉट ओनली अ वेल प्लान्ड एंड वेल मेड बिल्डिंग बट आल्सो अ बिल्डिंग व्हिच इज वेल मेंटेन्ड, वेयर सेफ्टी hygiene and sanitation are maintained on an ongoing basis, where the maintenance part of it is taken care of much deeper. So the flight to quality is going to happen across industries, and real estate and commercial real estate is not going to be any exception to that. The other side which I will try to cover a few points on is the hotel segment. Just for context, we operate the Novotel hotel in Calcutta, which is a 340 room hotel, and we are also partners with the Money Group in the JW Marriott, which is a 280 room hotel. So the hotel segment is probably one of the worst hit in the current times, as I'm sure all of you are not only reading, but it's something which we can intuitively understand. Nobody wants to go to a crowded place or even move out of your house at this point. So, of course, we will see a prolonged period of pain in this particular sector. But we are beginning to see, some avenues of alternate use. And, I will just stress on some of the positives which are coming out. So, you know, one of the things, of course, a lot of the hotels in the country and in the city have started, you know, giving out their rooms for voluntary quarantine, you know, for people who are don't have, COVID, but somebody in their family or somebody in their neighborhood might have, and they might want to be away, or somebody who has low immunity due to an existing other disease might want to be more secluded. So we are seeing a lot of hotel facilities being, you know, voluntary quarantine where there is no COVID or no symptoms at all. The other interesting use case which we are seeing is that a lot of companies, especially consultancies, are putting some of their employees in hotels to work for two reasons. One, they are saying that, you know, we don't have the kind of network speed, the kind of space in the houses of some of our people, and so especially some important people, we would much rather put them in a serviced apartment in a hotel or in a suite in a hotel where, you know, there is a ready infrastructure, high speed connection, food is available readily, etc. But also because a lot of the companies are saying that from a business continuity point of view, we want our teams to be spread in multiple locations. We want smaller teams in 3-4 locations. And of course, we are not taking up new space right now. So at least for a few months, let us put up people in hotels. And that is something which we are beginning to see. Apart from that, of course, the crew business, even today in Novotel, we have about 40 rooms occupied, 25-30 of which are between Indigo and SpiceJet crew. SpiceJet continues to operate cargo planes and air ambulances even in this time. So, you know, we are seeing some of that business come in. The other piece which we are realizing, and when we speak to all the experts in the industry, is that from a leisure perspective, we are going to see, you know, drive to destination. So in Calcutta, it could be Vedic Village, or it could be, Raichak, where people will first start to go. Because everybody is dying to go out of their house, take a small break. And nobody wants to get into a flight yet. Nobody wants to get onto a train. So we will see some of these leisure destinations where you can drive to come up faster. Each city has some multitude of places. You also have Diga, Mandarmuni, Mayapur, you know, so many of these places where people can drive to. So those will start operating, and, you know, Vedic Village, Raichak, you know, a lot of our fraternity has interest, and I'm sure we will see some of those coming. And business travel, we see starting to come back in the next quarter, starting with, you know, emergency travel and travel which of very high importance needs. So some of that will start to come in. But the one underlying thing which I must say for both of these asset classes, office and hotel, where typically the developer either owns the larger part of the asset or owns most the entire asset, is that in this difficult time, one of the things which we are finding difficult to grapple with is the bank part of it. You know, because businesses have come to a halt, but the bank interest, even when you and me are sleeping, the bank interest meter continues to work. So I think one of the important things which is required here is a one-time restructuring, where at least principal repayments, etc., can be pushed out, and possibly some kind of larger deferment of interest cost, if not waiver, you know, for a period of 9 to 12 months can come in. And of course, from CREDAI and from a number of other associations, we have made these representations both to RBI and the government. And I'm sure so has your association. So, you know, these were some of the thoughts. I thought I'll try to get a little more specific. So on office and hotel, these are some of my thoughts, and, happy to take up more questions as we move along.
Thank you, Apurvaji. Your comment on the slowdown was good. You said that, of course, work from home has become a fashion now, and we all think that it is going to continue. But I do agree with you that a large sector will not be able to adapt to this, particularly in view of the fact that this paperless working has not yet entered into our Indian genes or our working pattern or style, you know. So work from home for a larger section may not be appealing for a longer period. This idea was good, you know, that if the social distancing norms we have to maintain, then this sitting in the office, we may require a larger office. We may not like to sit cramped. This never hit my mind. Of course, a very good thing that you said. And this hotel thing you said, yes, people, companies have started shifting maybe a few senior people to these hotels, make them work from hotel. And this idea is also very well taken. We will have leisure destination because, yeah, next 1 or 2 years abroad holidays or traveling is a very bad idea. So these leisure holidays become leisure destination holidays, maybe. So that is going to see an swing. And this banking thing that you have said, of course, the whole industry we have been talking to, banking, restructuring, we have already heard that from. So the points are also very well taken, Apurvaji. So I move to the next panelist. Pamia, let's have your views, the youngest in the panel today.
First, I want to thank ACAE for giving me the honor to speak to an audience and a panel from whom I'm still learning today. So thank you for that so much. I want to speak on the positive side of why I feel demand should increase after the 2 or 3 months of, you know, panic, how Nandu uncle had quoted it, is first by stating something which Jinesh uncle had said in the beginning, which is that homes will have one room as offices. So he himself is admitting that whoever's going to do a work from home or the work from home concept is going to come. So a person will need a larger house. So which is what? They'll have to increase their real estate demand. So a person now, whenever he's choosing a house, he will keep that in mind that, you know, an extra space is good. This is now again being enforced in a person's mind because he's locked up in his house for so long that he's realizing the importance of space. And you have to realize now with the new, you know, with the low banking rates and the easy EMI payments and the attractive rates for which the developers are offering, a person can afford to buy that 500 square feet more, the 300 square feet more, the 200 square feet more at very easy terms. So this is a very positive side of real estate, which has happened in the lockdown as well. A person realizing the importance of space. Again, you know, something which I'm going to pick up on Sanjay Uncle's point where he said sales have happened. Sales have happened for our group as well and for other groups who I'm aware of. But more than sales, the existing customers are still paying the EMI payments and they're still paying the dues to us. You know, we've spoken to about 200 or 300 of our existing customers who are still in the booking phase or who are still in the EMI phase, and none of them have even said that we want to cancel yet. So that itself is showing that, you know, people are seeing the seeing real estate as a very solid asset class again. They're seeing that, you know, it's a physical asset class, it's a stable, secure asset class, and with the, you know, fixed deposit rates, which were supposed to be the most secure form of investment falling, real estate will now be start seeing as a long-term safe asset class. So all those things have been a very good change. Secondly, we have to realize in the cities, you know, people are still staying in very congested spaces. A huge population are staying in congested old properties, be it say in the old CBDs or the old areas like Bada Bazaar or whatever. So those people, you know, those areas are the ones which have been, are, you know, termed as a hot zone or the red zone. So people will have the mindset of buying, you know, properties in decongested spaces or buying properties in bigger complexes with more open space or shifting their offices from congested spaces to, you know, newer complexes which are coming up, which is keeping these in mind. So I think this will be a very big positive for real estate in the next 3 months. And with the festive season coming, which is the main season where our sales pick up, I think things will start settling down and we will see a good growth happening around October, November. Secondly, I just, you know, another point which I wanted to say is that, you know, a lot of people, I was just reading the chat group as well, were asking whether, you know, prices would come down or prices won't come down, you know, how it's going to happen. They have to realize that real estate has already absorbed a lot of price increase. You know, we've seen the GST input being withdrawn. So that, you know, that that cost increase has been absorbed by real estate developers. The RERA cost increase, the raw material increase, people are making better buildings. So all this cost has already been inbuilt to the developers' cost, and, you know, prices haven't increased to that extent. So this is to not burden the customers. We've not increased the prices. So real estate prices are already at a very, very attractive rate. So, you know, I feel that the opportunities which are going to come up for a customer to buy a house will be very exciting because the banks are cutting down on housing interest rates and the government is ready to give subsidies in form of e-registration by cutting, giving discounts on that.
PMAY.
Plus PMAY scheme, PMAY scheme has seen a good offtake. So I think in the long term, real estate will see a good growth. And like Apurva mentioned that, you know, people will move from, you know, earlier we were used to sitting, kya bolte the, charge unko saath mein bitha do. हाँ जितना जगह बच सकता है बचाओ, अब बोलेंगे नहीं थोड़ा दूर दूर रखो, बिजनेस को भी चलाना है, कोई बीमार नहीं हो जाए. सो ऑल दैट विल सी अ गुड ग्रोथ इन रियल एस्टेट ओवरऑल. वी हैव टू बी पेशेंट फॉर 2 or 3 months बिकॉज यू नो एवरीवन विल हैव टू रीसेटल, रीफिगर, रीअलाइन देमसेल्व्स. बट आई थिंक आफ्टर दैट देयर विल बी अ पॉजिटिव इम्पैक्ट ऑन रियल एस्टेट. And you know, we look forward to hearing from everyone on their thoughts now.
Thank you, Soumya. It was good from a young person like you, this patience suggestion on let us be patient for 2-3 months. And of course, you are also as positive as the other seniors in your profession were. Yes, your this one room office at home concept is now gaining, you know, in the minds of we consultant people and throughout. And your this comment on real estate prices are attractive as of now. I don't know. Some of us are putting in the chat boxes. They are not very satisfied. But of course, that is your comment, and the real estate industry would itself know where it is paying or whether the prices are correct. I think for one, you know, the land prices are too high in metro cities. So probably the top end projects are very, very costly for people to afford. But that was my personal observation. So, you know, in the chat boxes, we have a number of suggestions. Dilip Singh Mehtaji has said, of course, in the suggestion that we have given to the government, this COVID deduction may be put into the 35-2AB, you know, giving more than, if you donate 100, you'll be given a deduction of 150 or 125, 175. It was a good suggestion, Dilip Ji. I think in the next round that we send to the government, we will include this. I, for one, admit from this. You know, before we go to the chat box, there are a number of ticklish questions. One thing, Nanduji, aap hai, this migration wala kal se jo inhone shuru kiya, I, for one, am not able to understand if these migrant laborers are allowed to go back from their workplaces to their homes. So, hum industry chalu karwana chahte hai ki industry... तीन महीना, क्योंकि एक बार जो आदमी घर चला जाएगा और आपके रियल एस्टेट में तो माइग्रेंट्स वाले ही ज्यादा हैं, तो ये वापस कब आएंगे, कैसे आएंगे? हाउ डू यू स्टार्ट, आर यू गोइंग टू स्टार्ट और आर यू गोइंग टू स्टॉप द स्टार्ट? आई एम नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. कैन आई
गिरीश, दैट्स अ वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन, बट यू मस्ट नो दैट मोस्ट माइग्रेंट लेबर्स आर फ्रॉम बंगाल. सो इन दैट केस बंगाल इज बेटर ऑफ, सो देयर विल बी स्ट्रगल गोइंग फ्रॉम वन डिस्ट्रिक्ट टू द अदर डिस्ट्रिक्ट. But I think this could get resolved in a month's time. Most of the zones would become green or orange. So migration could happen within Bengal. So the thing, good thing is that most migrant laborers are from Bengal and Jharkhand. So that way Bengal in terms of construction labor will not have a struggle. Because most of Bengal workers work outside Bengal. Whether it's Kerala, Tamil Nadu, North, it's laborers from Bengal going. So Bengal is that way better off. So we should have a struggle. But other states would have a struggle if they come back to their hometowns. Now the sense of fear is there, insecurity is there. So they may not want to go back to another town so easily and so fast. So I think we shouldn't have a struggle, but other states would have a struggle in the short to long term. Maybe up to 6 months, people will not go back so easily to other towns to work. That is the struggle.
Yeah. No. So we are at an advantage, Bengal, vis-a-vis the other states. Absolutely. Is what I could take, understand what you said. But in a larger perspective, the whole country migrants going back, 10, 20, 25% may not return back. And for the next 3 months, at least, they are not going to return back. So there is a challenge facing the whole industry, the factories, and particularly the real sector. So if you say that Bengal will have an advantage vis-a-vis others, so your labor cost...
In terms of real estate, the construction industry. Most construction workers are from Bengal.
So if that be so, do we foresee a real... price reduction in the realty sector in the future? Many of our members would like to know that. Jab aapka construction cost ghatega kya? Can we look at a lower?
So cost to ghatta hi nahi hai because we are always price going up. But you have to understand one thing. What does a real estate developer do today? He buys the land or he goes into a joint venture and he puts the construction cost.
Right.
So his profit is, the real estate developer doesn't make big money. It is the person who has held on to the land who makes the big money, not the real estate developer. Developer hardly makes any money. He buys the land or goes into a JV. So there's a land cost involved. And after that, he has to put in the construction cost. So the profit for a developer is not high. In the good old days, when the prices were rising, speculative profit was there. A developer profit is not there. Speculative profits is there basically on land only. So I don't think many real estate developers are holding on to land. They either have to develop it or give it back to the landowner. So I think this is a misconception of most people that developers are making a lot of money. Developers made money when the prices jumped in maybe 3 years, but that's not happening for the last 10 years. So real estate developers are not making money. They're losing money today with high interest rates and high construction costs.
Well, that coming from today, I would.
In today's world, it is. I think you have to look into the balance sheets of developers. Since you're from the profession, you should look at the balance sheets, how much they're suffering, the real estate developers, in terms of interest cost and finance cost.
That I do agree with you. It was in a lighter way, of course. But as I said, I have also commented that the land prices are so big. But what happens to this all this land bank in the country, in the rural and semi-rural areas also? Huge land banks held by so many companies. Why are they not getting unleashed and converting into real estate if the prices have to be really brought down? Or if the concentration of population also has to now reduce, density has to reduce, the areas have to expand. So why not cities expand? Why not these unused land banks be used? What is your take on this?
I think with infrastructure development, the metro connectivity, the roads improving, decondition definitely take place. People will surely shift to the suburban areas, but infrastructure has to move at a faster pace. People will shift, definitely move out. And I see a correction in land in the suburban areas for sure, where there's large tracts of land available. And with the infrastructure, land prices will come up. Within the cities, I don't see land prices correcting in the near future, because there's always a pressure and centralized, there's less land available. But in the suburban areas, I do see some kind of correction in the land prices, for sure.
When there is a land price correction, maybe the project prices go down and...
In the suburban areas, but suburban areas are hardly a margin for anybody. The prices are 3,000, 4,000 rupees a square feet in the suburban areas.
Mm-hmm. Jitu, please, Jitu, can you unmute yourself and...
Yeah, I'm there.
A number of questions in the chat box, most of them are suggestions or repetitions.
Yeah. So there is one question to Nandita that in this post-COVID time, so the participant are of the opinion or other are seeking suggestion that after post-COVID time, this flat, office, jewelry, this will not be the last item.
Not clear. I can't hear you. It's not clear. Your voice is clear.
Sir, we have a question that this flat, jewelry, offices, and cars, these items will not be a last thing which an investor would be willing to invest in next coming 6 months to 1 year. So, what is your opinion in this regard?
I think everybody needs a home. Factory, these are expanding. I don't think homes would definitely be on top of the list. You feel more secure. You need more space when you work from home, or even if you have to spend more time at home, you need a bigger home. I think real estate for homes grow. I don't see demand for homes. Well, you can say subsequent investments in real estate where you want to invest part of will be definitely slow initially, but I think first of all, normal development. The first home person always family is expanding, they'll definitely go for a home. Where do they have to keep buying homes when the family grows?
Yes, very rightly said.
To the larger question, Nanduji, what I think was trying to pose is we are an investor class. Ghar to mere paas ek rehne ka hai.
Sorry?
Investor class, jo hum log apna portfolios ka ek certain percentage hum log में लगा के रखते हैं फ्रॉम द कमर्शियल टू रेसिडेंशियल पोर्शन और शुड बी शिफ्ट टोटली ऑप्ट आउट ऑफ दिस व्हाट इज योर टेक आई मीन वेल यू फोर ऑफ यू आर सिटिंग हियर व्हाट इज योर
सो आई डिड कैन यू रिपीट बिकॉज़ इट्स जस्ट ब्रेकिंग द
व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज वी एज इन्वेस्टर्स हैव अ परसेंटेज ऑफ आवर पोर्टफोलियो इन्वेस्टेड इन रियल्टी वी हैव बैंक एफडी स्टॉक मार्केट रियल्टी एंड गोल्ड Right, world over, and that is investment pattern. So, should we go more into the realty vis-a-vis the other investments, or in India particularly, or maybe Bengal, or should we shift our investments from office and commercial to residential more because we have now from home concept, or should we keep on buying a room in a hotel for a year and then up will be more expensive?
I think
more happy.
No, see, I cannot totally advise on how you divide your portfolio in terms of real estate, gold, or stock. This is something I think in an instable world, when there's instability, when there's insecurity, people look at more liquid assets like gold or keeping it in cash or FDs. But I think once stability comes in, maybe next 6 months or 1 year, I think we'll go back to our old portfolio that we're investing. Gold is always a liquid asset. Real estate is not very volatile, but it's something you can hold on to and also use it for future generations, as it lasts for generations. So I think initially people would be investing more in liquid because of insecurity, but going forward, I think we'll be back to where we were investing. I think all, but I always am apprehensive of stocks the way they've crashed this time. I don't know how things will behave going forward, but when economies get stable and things get stable, I think even stock market will stabilize. Portfolios will, I think real estate would be a strong investment going forward too. That's what a real estate developer always tell you.
Yes. Sir, we have one, we have one more question, that is it not the right time whether you see the real estate player industry and also the professionals should, you see, ask the state government to revise this circle rate issue, because Bengal is most hit actually. We see the circle rates are way high, the actual market rate. So they may not reduce the stamp duty rate, but this circle rate correction is much required to again lift up the mood of real estate sector in this part of India.
Nandu, we have to put it clear, we are asking the central government to reduce those 43C and 53C rates. Immediately, we can.
I just heard part of the question regarding circle rates. No?
Yeah.
But, I will answer, Nandu Bhaiya. The thing is, we should be, the CREDAI is speaking to IGR for various appropriate money, correcting the circle rates which are higher. And they have done and reduced it in some time in last 1 year's time in many areas. But I think at this moment that may be difficult, because the priority of the state government would be to earn revenue, and they may not go so aggressively and reduce the circle rate. So that can happen, but that will move very slow on a particular segment. But don't foresee
आज एटलीस्ट प्रोफेशनली मोस्ट ऑफ अस प्रोफेशनल्स फील कि लिक्विडिटी इसमें नहीं आता है जब तक ये चर्निंग मैं अपना यूनिट बेचूं नहीं तो दूसरा लोग लेट देयर बी अ लेस सर्कल लेट यू मे इंक्रीज योर स्टैंप ड्यूटी 6-8% भी कर दो ना बट ये चर्निंग लिक्विडिटी जब तक नहीं आएगा तब तक ये चर्निंग होगा ना अलाउ दीज फ्लैट्स टू सेल अब कितना अनसोल्ड इन्वेंटरी आपके पास यहां पड़ा है बंगाल में
इसलिए भी स्टाफ है दे वी हैव अ मीटिंग विद आईजीआर प्रोबेबली टुडे टुमारो वी बी टॉकिंग अबाउट हम लोग ट्राई पूरा कर रहे हैं बट जो है वो बहुत हाई नहीं है आप ये करेक्ट बोल रहे हैं कि अगर चर्निंग ज्यादा होगा तो आपका रेवेन्यू तो सेम हो जाएगा बट at this difficult time with state government having their constraint with central se paisa kitna aa raha hai kya aa raha hai sab jagah ke beech mein whether they will take this drastic step of reducing the but CREDAI is trying there is a meeting in a day or
we have made a representation to the finance minister and the finance secretary for reduction of the circle rates in many areas but not some areas is realistic but some areas is a bit high So we have made the representation, and government looks at their revenue also. So they are not very keen to reduce it. But we at our end, in the post-COVID world, we have made an appeal that now we need to reduce this so that resales, like Jinesh ji bol rahe hain, resales happen faster in the secondary market. So let's see what they say. We are definitely at it. Let's hope for the best.
अच्छी प्रोफेशनली हम लोग तो डायरेक्ट टैक्स इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स का सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट को भेजते हैं वो भेजते रहेंगे बट क्रेडा ही ले सकते हैं सर्कल रेट वाला इशू तो वी कैन टेक अप
आई आई थिंक मोर सो इफ यू कैन वर्क विद द विद दिस सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एंड टेल देम दिस 43 एंड 53 जो भी आपके दो सेक्शंस हैं दिस शुड बी डन अवे विद बिकॉज़ नाउ कैश ट्रांजैक्शन नो मोर देयर इन द रियल एस्टेट बिजनेस लेट्स बी फ्रैंक 99% ऑफ ट्रांजैक्शंस आर अबव बोर्ड नाउ सो आई थिंक स्क्रैपिंग ऑफ दिस प्रोविजन इज मोर इंपॉर्टेंट I think that way you all should approach through your lobby and scrapping of this provision is more important today. I feel
very very correct. वो कर भी रहे, बट स्टेट को भी ये मैं थोड़ा कमी कर दो ना, ब्लैक मनी घुसती तो अभी चर्निंग होगा, लिक्विडिटी घूमेगा तब तो ये
इन्वेस्टर क्लास। हां वो तो कर ही रहे, अभी वो बोल ही रहे
यूट्यूब चैट बॉक्स से उठाओ और क्वेश्चंस यूट्यूब प्लीज।
देयर इज वन क्वेश्चन, करेंटली द नॉशनल रेंट इज चार्ज ऑन अनसोल्ड प्रॉपर्टीज बियॉन्ड, एक्चुअली दिस इज बेसिकली पर्टेनिंग टू द इनकम टैक्स एक्चुअली व्हिच इज देयर, सो आई डोंट थिंक दिस इज द राइट फॉरम। It's mostly about the comment, Jinesh, we are in the chat box, which I find.
I can't hear. I don't
know. Yeah, yeah. Your Nanubia, your voice is breaking, I think. I mean, hello?
My voice. My voice is breaking.
Yes, breaking.
Can you hear it now without the video?
Yeah, yeah. I think that's clear now. Jinesh, is it clear? The voice is clear?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Bully.
Yes, yes. So, because we have, I do not have much question directly in the chat box, which we can put forward, or someone we can unmute and ask.
Shanti Gupta ko unmute karo bhai, Shanti Bhaiya ko kuch bolne do.
Bhaiya, Arun Agarwal ji ka question hai, unko unmute kariye na please.
Arun ko unmute karo, Shanti Bhaiya ko unmute karo, they have a lot of things.
Yes, yes. Arun Bhaiya, you are unmuted now.
Thank you, Jitu. Yeah, good morning, Apoorv. You made some points, very pertinent points. One point I think, if I'm not wrong, you were making is that because of this COVID-19 and social distancing and all, now commercial spaces requirement may increase and that may increase the demand for commercial properties, right?
Sure.
I just have some apprehension on that. On the other end, what I was thinking, my personal, very small mind, that because of this COVID-19 and all, work from home, new culture coming up in India, as you said, culture is not new. It was limited to some sectors. Now, everybody has learned video conferencing. Everyone is doing video conferencing day and night from sitting up at home. So like, we are also about to move to our new office in some time, maybe in a month or two. So we were also thinking that is it on the other way around, that is it not a bad investment to make such a huge investment in real estate property in view of the development that now actually work from home would be more practical, more realistic. So probably much bigger office spaces may not be required really. So is that not a right thinking, or is there any balancing or trade-off between the two you suggested?
You're absolutely right. You know, I think one of the things which I did mention before I came, let's see, even before I answer a question, you know, I'm seeing a number of things on the chat. Let me just give one little background. You know, I think a lot of people are probably getting a feeling that, you know, we are not giving a correct picture, or, you know, we are being overtly optimistic. You know, my humble submission is that, see, the pain we are all aware of, you know, what the not only our sector, but all the other businesses are also feeling, we are all aware of. So what as a panel and as a group we are trying to see is that, you know, of course this pain is there and the next few months are going to be painful. But what are the positives that we can look at so that we can work in a positive mind frame from today, so that when the opportunity comes, we are ready. So my humble request is that please take our comments and thoughts in that context. And in terms of what you asked, you rightly said, see, absolutely, you know, the first point which I had said on that also is that some amount of work from home will happen. Also, see, people will look at, you know, do I need to bring everybody to office every day? You know, even if I have the same number of people, can, you know, Monday, say Wednesday, 75% will come, and, you know, Tuesday to Thursday, 75 will come, I will have an overlap. It is not absolutely exclusive. So you are absolutely right. I independently spoke of these trends and they will also net off. The other thing also which you mentioned is that, you know, where you are looking at in terms of whether I should buy or whether I should put in so much money. See, that is a trend. Let's say, for example, most of our office portfolio, which is in the south, in Bangalore and Hyderabad, is entirely leased. And I think that is a trend we will see more and more of, where instead of buying a capital asset, you are saying, I will, you know, lease the asset. And, you know, people like you and me who, you know, who don't have thousands of people in IT, etc. You know, we will still say that let us lease our office. And then we will have another person, the third guy who will come and say, okay, now I will buy this as an investment. Just like today we are buying rent yielding property. So for the developer, the option will still exist. But I think, you know, a lot of capex will move to, just like the software industry, we are seeing SaaS. पहले हम माइक्रोसॉफ्ट का लाइसेंस खरीदते थे, अभी हम यू नो एनुअल SaaS फीस दे रहे हैं. सो आई थिंक अ लॉट ऑफ दोस थिंग्स आर कमिंग टू लॉट ऑफ कैपिटल एसेट्स. एंड यू राइटली पॉइंटेड आउट दैट यू नो सम ऑफ दिस ट्रेंड्स विल काउंटर बैलेंस ईच अदर टू सम एक्सटेंट. सो वी विल, आई एम नॉट एक्सपेक्टिंग दैट द ऑफिस सेक्टर विल स्टार्ट टू बूम समटाइम सून, बट यू नो द वर्क फ्रॉम होम इम्पैक्ट, द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ न्यू ऑफिस लीजिंग इमीडिएटली नॉट हैपनिंग. Some of this will get negated with the requirement of social distancing. That is the submission that I have tried to make.
Thank you. You know, Apurvaji, our Arun ji is also very positive, like you all are. Maybe he was talking to, he was, you know, but in fact, in a lighter end, let me tell you, you know, he's an interesting expert.
I know him very well.
ये क्या करेंगे अभी, ये पॉजिटिविटी को डीम वैल्यू लगा के इस पे जीएसटी लगाना चाहिए करके सरकार को आएगा.
We also have Dinesh Bia, SS Gupta ji. Gupta ji, please, you have.
We have Dilip Singh Mehta who wants to speak after SS Gupta. Unko bhi unmute kar dena.
Yes, 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 I'll do it.
Yeah,
Gupta ji, yeah, you are.
First of all, greetings to all the learned speakers. My one suggestion which CREDAI should make to government, though from our association we have already made these suggestions, that this notional taxation on account of 43 CA and 50C and notional taxation of this unsold commercial properties, that should be very strictly taken up with the government, because we are, I mean, people are not making real profits. So instead of taxing real income, government is trying to tax notional taxation by virtue of 43 CA and 50C and 23.5, that is notional rent taxation. You know, gone are the days when these cash transactions, you have so many other avenues which disentitle you, which discourage you from entering into cash transactions. Therefore, under the present scenario, there is no reason. So CREDAI should make a very, in the strongest possible terms, this representation should be made. That is what I wanted to speak.
We have taken these issues. We have taken up these issues on a regular basis, and post-COVID and during COVID, we have taken up all these issues. And you know, we are now, we are more a socialist country than a capitalist country. The government looks at taxing us more and less and giving it more amongst the people. So we have taken it up. Let's hope in this present scenario we get some positive results.
Do unmute Dilip Singh Mehta ji ko, please.
Yeah, I'm unmuted.
Dilip ji, you are unmuted, please.
Yeah, good afternoon, my fellow builders and fellow professionals.
Hi Dilip. Hi Dilip.
Welcome on this social bonding page. I don't agree with social distancing. It's more physical distancing and social bonding. And that's exactly what we are doing. Now, I am not very much overboard so far as the idea of working from home is concerned, for a very simple reason that on this particular platform, you will find people's voice going off, faces going off, sounds going off, scratches coming in. And that's exactly what's going to happen if everybody starts working from home, or most of them start working from home. Because India does not have enough pipe or a bandwidth to sustain or control any kind of traffic that you're looking at if people start, or any majority or even a minority start working from home. I'll just share a very quick short example that we are also into education, and the classes, the examinations which have been planned to go online have been cancelled. Because not more than 16% of the people in Bengal have access to bandwidth, the kind of bandwidth that is required for holding an exam, or the kind of bandwidth that is required to even hold a virtual classroom. So I think we are definitely looking into a future which doesn't exist at the moment. But yes, for health reasons, physical distancing is definitely going to be an issue. And more office spaces will be required, but I presume the rents will remain the same. And I think that's the only thing I can sort of ambitiously look forward to. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dilip.
Nandu, you have kuch bolenge kya aap?
No, I said thank you, Dilip, for voicing our positive bent and talking about the
my basic view was that if we are looking at work from home, I think we are going overboard in calculating the actual need. It's not going to happen the way the whole world is, you know, sort of going into it, because we are looking at a bandwidth constraint, which is so severe, which is there on this platform also right now when we are talking Zoom.
Work from home will bring family issues also.
I am having a great time. Thank you very much.
Nandubhaiya, that is your age factor, you know, actually.
Dilip is on the right side.
Enjoying working from home. I don't think many of the younger youth would enjoy working from home.
Anyway, past 65 guys are anyway supposed to stay at home till the actual lockdown is lifted. Yeah. So it's okay with us.
Dilip, to what you said, you know, seriously, what I feel is आपका education sector तो फिर भी बहुत जल्दी work from home में convert हो सकता है, contrary to what you say. But what I'm saying is the industry or including the part of the professionals, you know, litigation, we are not used to this paperless working in our country.
That's right.
I feel that I have to plead before an AO. हम लोग faceless अभी हुआ नहीं है. Courts are not able to hear on. So we are not yet in this faceless or paperless scheme of thing, you know. As compared to the Western world or many developed countries, where this paperless is, accounts banata sab papers pe chalta hai.
Let me, Dinesh, I'll just share a short example with you. There was a mediation going on in the US yesterday, and the mediator was interacting with both the sides in two rooms and completely paperless. And it was a fantastic experience. It happened for 2 hours, and a lot of results came out. So things are going to evolve, but end of the day, you need the gateway. You need the bandwidth.
Bandwidth है ना अभी जियो आ रहा है बॉस अभी क्यों घबरा रहे हैं? You can like to it. So let us all be positive. So, you know, the takeaway from all this is the positivity of reality is positive. ठीक है ना नंदू भैया?
Yes, absolutely. Positive is most important. If you're not positive, then we are all in trouble. We all have to be positive to get a better tomorrow. And I think every crisis teaches us new things, and new skills come up, and new ways of working come up. And there's a positive to everything. We shouldn't be, like I said, from 1900 to 1950 saw worse times. We've seen very great times. It is the first time we've got this circuit breaker, and we'll come out of it surely.
You know, to put it in a little blunt way, let us all be opportunists. Isme bhi hum log opportunity khojo kuch aur karo, tab to positive aayega.
Dinesh bhaiya, we have Tarun, our convener. Tarun, you can unmute yourself and please ask the question. What you have?
Yeah, am I
Tarun? Audible? Yeah, you're audible. Please go on.
Yeah. I just wanted to ask one question to the panelists. Anyone can answer that. Going forward, are we going to see lot of mixed space utilization, like residential, commercial, institutional, all in say close proximity? Rather than what generally currently we have, that they are say in distances. So what is the idea on that? Thank you.
What's the question? Can I get it once again? Because you were not very clear.
Sorry, the question, is it clear now?
Yeah. Tell me.
The question is that going forward, are we going to see more of mixed space utilization? Like
mixed space.
Yeah. Residential, okay. Commercial, institutional, all in close proximity.
Well, I was hearing to some talks in the US. They were saying that clusters will develop, which are all self-contained, residential. They were talking on those lines. But I think once the people are over this, your COVID, and vaccine is out, I think people will come back to the normal life slowly. I think things will get normal in the next 2 years. Once the vaccine is out, people will come back to the original lives. It's not that panic will keep continuing. We have to look at that the vaccine will also be out maybe in a year, 18 months. So 18 months are trouble. 18 months people are insecure. But post that, I think things would normalize the way we are living today, with hygiene playing a major important part, for sure.
Okay, thank you, sir.
I think you know the Jitu or question is health sector mein aapka realty ka bahut kaam aayega. Health sector mein there is going to be a lot of spending in the hospitals and nursing homes and all this. The next 5 years, they say we spend even less than 1% of our GDP on health. Our country, world over, I think the attention will be towards health. What I see. So, आप बिना जगह का क्या करेंगे? So, a lot of your space is going to be consumed there. Jitu, you have any further question in the chat box?
Not as such, all are comment actually. One question I have, how to keep the current tenant intact? They are started asking for reduction. How to take decision under this uncertain environment due to COVID? It's more of a, you see, in the, asking that, how do we rather control the situation where our tenants are asking for a reduction?
Apurva, you want to answer that?
Sure, happy to answer that. Yeah, I think the one reality we must understand is that if the tenant goes, today to get a replacement is virtually impossible. So, having said that, it does not mean that whatever the tenant is asking for, we need to give. So, what we are doing across different properties is that starting with the realization ki abhi tenant jayega to dusra is small mein to nahi milne wala hai. Jo milega wo 4-6 mahine baad hi milega. So, with that, we are negotiating ki bhai, let us understand ki aapko kya zarurat hai. With the larger tenants, you know, they are asking for some kind of deferral. With some of the smaller tenants, वो बोल रहे हैं कि हमको आप 3 महीने के लिए कुछ variable पे डाल दीजिए. They are willing to share their metrics. समझिए अगर you know there is a small restaurant in the in our IT park, they are willing to share कि भाई you know I will share my POS data, my point of sale data with you, and you know let us fix this percentage and you know these slabs. So with smaller businesses, they are needing a little more support. With larger businesses, it's a time support, and you know right now with banks also having given the deferment, we are kind of giving that back to back. I don't know how the bank deferment will go back, you know, forward. But in short, what we are doing is we are doing everything in possible to keep the tenant, because aaj jayega to aaj ke din dusra milna bahut mushkil.
Rightly said. We have last question from Arunji. You are unmuted. You can speak now.
Arunji, before you come, one minute. Ek chat box mein ek interesting force measure ka baat hamare member ne pooch liya hai. I didn't really want to ask you, but then they're there. Ab jaise ye 3 mahine ke liye deliveries late honge complexes flats, aur yahan pe jo final payments jo karne wale the 3 mahine mein, wo log bhi late karenge. What is your view? Aapko interest lagayenge force measure karke ki ya delivery late karenge to client log force measure karenge nahi de paaye hain? I mean.
The delay in possession would also have to be approved by the HERA authorities, which they surely will. This is a pandemic, it is a force measure. So definitely, I think delayed possession would not attract any penalty once the HERA authorities give the approval. And similarly, if the customer has to pay after when he gets possession, he will not be charging interest for the delay during the COVID period.
So I think we would also suggest to the guy, we can't advise, we can suggest that let there be a two-way traffic. If you take a call, the delayed running over of projects 3 mahina chalayenge, to fir delayed payment bhi 3 mahina ka interest charge mat kijiye. I don't name, but you know, we some of us have faced it. Phone aane lage ki aapka payment nahi aaya hai. We guy ko call le lena chahiye ki two-way traffic hona chahiye.
We'll put it forward, taking your suggestion. I cannot speak on behalf of all the developers. I'll take your point and put it forward for sure.
That is a suggestion.
I just want to add to this point from what you said. Developers are charging money only after they're completing the construction. So the demands which we're asking for is only after that work is complete. So agar possession ya wo kaam delay hoga, to uska payment bhi hum log baad mein mangenge.
No, dear, wo monthly payments ke bhi kahi hote hain.
He's talking about the buildings under construction and installment due.
Soumya, and वो क्या 15 मार्च को आपने कोई raise किया है? 20 मार्च को office बंद हो गई. अब वो 20 मई के पहले नहीं. आप 2 महीने का interest charge कर लेंगे फट करके. So there are going to be dispute. So we don't want that type of dispute to unnecessarily be a bad error.
But Dinesh ji, हम लोग को government ने कहा धंधा बंद कर दो. 2 महीने के लिए बंद कर दिया, पर बैंक तो ब्याज ले रहे हैं. हम लोग रात को सोते हैं, ब्याज देना ही पड़ता है. ब्याज तो बंद नहीं हुआ हम लोग
का. अच्छा भाई, हम प्रोफेशनल्स की फीस तो देंगे ना, वो तो 2 महीना
ब्याज बंद करेंगे 6 महीने के लिए. हम लोग गवर्नमेंट से ब्याज बंद करेंगे, बैंक से 6 महीने के लिए बंद करेंगे.
चलिए दैट इज ऑल अरुण को लो भी जीतू
यस
बेलानी जी आई जस्ट हैड टू पॉइंट्स मे बी टू सजेशंस यू कैन से ऑल्दो जिनेश जी मेरे ऊपर हमेशा इल्जाम लगाते रहते हैं कि हमेशा जीएसटी लगाने की बात करता है
लाइटर वेन
बट यू नो रियल एस्टेट के लिए मैं हमेशा ही बात करता हूं कि रियल एस्टेट में कैसे रैशनलाइज हो सिंपलीफाइड हो अभी रियल एस्टेट में एक जो इशू आ रहा है रेंट के ऊपर जो अभी बात हो रही थी तो रेंट के ऊपर में अभी मैं अगर रेंट का बिल कंटिन्यू करूं रेजिंग इनवॉइसेस फॉर रेंटिंग कमर्शियल प्रॉपर्टी स्पेशली जीएसटी लायबिलिटी मेरी इमीडिएटली आ जा रही है जबकि पेमेंट अभी रेंट का आएगा कि नहीं फोर्स मेजर क्लॉजेस की बात हो रही है मेरे को एट ऑल वो पैसा मिलेगा कि नहीं कम मिलेगा ज्यादा मिलेगा वी डू नॉट नो तो ये बहुत बड़ा बर्डन काफी जगह पे आ रहा है तो इसके ऊपर में भी गवर्नमेंट पार्टी ये सजेशन तो करना चाहिए आप लोग देखे होंगे ऑलरेडी एक पॉइंट डिस्कस हो रहा है कि जीएसटी को बिलिंग बेसिस से रियलाइजेशन बेसिस पे शिफ्ट किया जा सकता है कि तो लार्जली ओवरऑल तो आई डोंट थिंक कि ये हो पाएगा मेरे को पर्सनली मेरे को नहीं लगता वो हो पाएगा लेकिन पर्टिकुलरली रेंट के केस में रियल एस्टेट सेक्टर में इस तरह की जब सिचुएशन है ऑलरेडी मैटर कोर्ट्स में है तो वी कैन मेक अ रिप्रेजेंटेशन अ स्ट्रॉन्ग रिप्रेजेंटेशन कि इसमें थोड़ा वेवर का कुछ प्रोविजन गवर्नमेंट को लाना चाहिए नंबर वन तो इंटरेस्ट बिल्कुल नहीं लगना चाहिए क्योंकि अगर मैं इनवॉइस नहीं रेज करता हूँ अभी तो मेरा क्लेम ही बाद में डिस्प्यूटेबल हो जाएगा इसलिए इनवॉइस तो मेरे को रेज करना पड़ेगा लेकिन मेरा लायबिलिटी अभी इमीडिएटली नहीं आ जाए या अगर आए भी तो बाद में मैं लेट भी पेमेंट करता हूँ तो विदाउट एनी इंटरेस्ट और मैं क्रेडिट नोट इशू कर सकता हूँ बिकॉज फर्स्ट से देर इज अ व्यू कि क्रेडिट नोट भी शायद मैं नहीं इशू कर पाऊंगा अगर मेरे को सपोज रेंट मेरे को मिलता ही नहीं है तो प्रोबेबली अगर मैंने इनवॉइस रेज कर दिया तो बाद में क्रेडिट नोट भी नहीं रेज करूँ तो ये एक बड़ा इशू आएगा आ रहा है रदर तो मेरे ख्याल से इसके ऊपर में बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग एक रिप्रेजेंटेशन होना चाहिए गवर्नमेंट
और एक
सेकेंड पॉइंट जो संजय जैन जी प्रोबेबली वाज मेकिंग अ पॉइंट रिगार्डिंग सम जीएसटी एंड इनकम टैक्स इंसेंटिव्स एंड बेनिफिट्स मतलब फॉर रियल एस्टेट सेक्टर उसमें अ वेरी वैलिड पॉइंट व्हिच ही मेड इज अलाउइंग इनपुट टैक्स क्रेडिट ऑफ रियल एस्टेट अपने को मालूम है एज ऑफ नाउ रियल एस्टेट का इनपुट टैक्स क्रेडिट नहीं मिलता है इफ यू गो बाय द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ जीएसटी तो इनपुट टैक्स क्रेडिट नहीं मिलने का देयर इज नो रीजन no reason to disallow input tax credit in respect of real estate. The only thing is, at least government को हम लोग अभी इतना तो बोलना ही चाहिए कि if not full input tax credit in one go, तो आप इसको stagger कर दो over a period of 5 years, monthly installment करके कि मेरा total GST जितना है उसका 60 divided by 60 करके monthly basis पे इतना input tax credit मेरे को allow करो. इस तरह का एक representations तो हमारा बहुत validly and genuinely किया जा सकता है. These are the two points I think we should take up.
Yeah, the first point we are totally agreement with you that it should be on receipt basis the GST to be paid to the government, not on billing. And we have already taken up this matter. CREDAI National has already written this regard. It's part of our demands from the government. And let's hope for the best. And as far as second point is concerned, we'll definitely take your advice on that. And we'll connect with you and take up this. Sure. Thank you.
Sir, one more question which is there in the chat. That post this COVID, whether renting will, you see, people will get more, I mean, towards renting than the ownership or vice versa? I mean, how do you feel it?
This is, Apurva, you want to talk
sure. about it? Sure, I think as far as offices are concerned, offices and residential behave very differently. You know, with residential, there is a lot more emotion attached, there is a lot more personal angle. So I don't think resident in the residential segment, plus you know what has happened as we talk to number of people, number of consultants, lot of people who were on rent have been mistreated by landlords ki bhai tum aisa nahi kar sakte ho, COVID ka ye problem hoga, wo hoga. So on the residential side we are seeing more and more people wanting ki bhai aaj mera ghar hota to acha hota. So more and more people are wanting to buy a house. Of course this is going to be manifest slowly because people are also concerned about their jobs and the security of their salary for the next. So as this stabilizes, I think we will see a larger wave of buying coming in the residential side. But on the office side, it is more about usage. It is not the emotional or angle is much lesser in most cases. So there, you know, in fact, we were on a CREDAI and ICC startup call yesterday where there were a couple of startups who are working on even within the complex for developers how to move to a SaaS like model for things like generators, for things like solar panels, etc. So increasingly I think in terms of capital assets, just like the software industry has moved from you know, product software to SaaS software, software as a service, lot of capex, because cash flow, as we know, is the biggest challenge for everybody. Lot of these in the, at least in the short to medium term, lot of the capex expenditure is likely to move to opex expenditure, which means from buying to renting. Having said that, there is, you know, we are segregating two different uses. We are segregating usage and financial ownership. So the end user will go for renting, but there is a buyer, you know, some of you who might be interested in having it in your asset portfolio, they will still continue to buy it for the rent yield. You are not buying for usage. So usage and financial returns are being segregated, and I think that is the way forward.
Yes, Sarunji. You're unmuted, Anuji.
Are we done? Sure.
Oh, sorry, sir. Yes, sir, please.
One more thing I would like to talk about. That is regarding this joint venture, joint development agreement. You know that the entire country is facing this issue of dealing with joint ventures, especially in GST we are talking about. Income tax mein uska treatment alag hai, GST mein uska treatment alag hai. So real estate ko leke, main kahi par bolta hu aap logo, ki real estate specific policy government ko lana chahiye. To credit ki taraf se hum logo ko ye impress upon karna chahiye government ko ki aap real estate specific policy kyun nahi sochte, including all direct taxes, income tax, indirect taxes, or stamp duty for that matter, everything. Sale of real estate ka jo meaning real estate mein hoga, jo meaning stamp duty ke liye hoga, wahi meaning income tax mein hoga, wahi meaning GST mein hoga, something like that. To aisa ek document hum log abhi just now after I raised the issues, do teen log mere ko call kiye, bole ki aap ek bar is issue ko bhi raise kijiye since you all are there in the panel. To probably aisa ek thoda deep thoughtful ek paper jana chahiye government. पूरा जो इशू को डील किया गया है रियल एस्टेट में जीएसटी में जिस तरह से हैंडल किया गया, दिस हैज बीन वेरी बैडली मिसहैंडल्ड. तो ये गवर्नमेंट लोग, गवर्नमेंट के ऑफिसर्स जो है वो प्रोबेबली दे आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द नाइसिटीज ऑफ द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ अरेंजमेंट्स इन रियल एस्टेट. मैंने स्पेसिफिकली, सम ऑफ यू मे बी अवेयर आल्सो, मैंने स्पेसिफिकली गवर्नमेंट के जो जीएसटी काउंसिल में जो ऑफिसर्स है लॉ कमेटी के, उनके साथ में रियल एस्टेट को लेके कई वाइटल इश्यूज पे काफी डिस्कस किया था. उसके बाद में जो लास्ट जो न्यू पॉलिसी आई थी गवर्नमेंट की, उसमें रियल एस्टेट में कुछ एक चेंजेस आए थे, जैसे डेवलपमेंट राइट वगैरह को एग्जेम्प्ट किया गया था टू सम एक्सटेंट, वो सब उसके बाद ही हुआ था. तो वन वेरी सीनियर ऑफिसर सेड कि अरुण जी, आपसे ये मीटिंग के पहले तो हमको लग रहा था कि रियल एस्टेट सिंपल इन जीएसटी, बट आज आप लोगों के साथ ये डिस्कशन करके लग रहा है कि इट इज सो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, इतने सारे इश्यूज है विच आर अनएड्रेस्ड, विच आर नॉट एड्रेस्ड. तो मेरे ख्याल से अभी भी उनको बहुत जाने की जरूरत है. प्रोबेबली इसको और थोड़ा सा डीपली अगर देखें तो ये पर्टिकुलरली जो जॉइंट डेवलपमेंट एग्रीमेंट वगैरह को लेके वी कैन हैव सम इंपैक्ट ऑन देम.
राइट सर, योर पॉइंट वेल टेकन. वी विल टेक यू ऑन बोर्ड एंड वी विल सिंपली वर्क विद क्रेडाई नेशनल, अपनी जो नेशनल टीम है व्हिच इज इन टच विद द सेंटर ऑन रेगुलर बेसिस. वी विल टेक योर इनपुट्स एंड डेफिनेटली टेक इट अप विद देम ऑल द इश्यूज दैट यू रेज्ड डीलिंग रियल एस्टेट एज अ सेपरेट इंडस्ट्री ऑल टुगेदर.
अरुण जी जैसे आप लोग को एकदम ऐसा सजेशन देते हैं, पब्लिक सजेशन दे रहे हैं.
आपके लिए बात किया, आई थिंक वी शुड गेट फ्री एडवाइस फॉर द नेक्स्ट 5 इयर्स नाउ. ओके.
Thank you all for a formal word.
Yeah, let us put it this way. ACA can definitely work with CREDAI, and you see the taxation part of this, definitely we can represent before the state government and the central government, and because we have a lot of tax experts with us, so definitely we can jointly join hands and other work towards the greater benefit of real sector. And friends, let me tell you, today we had a lot of positive thought. Yes, the industry is going through a grim situation. Not only this industry, almost all industry in India is suffering this problem, but a very positive thought by all our panelists. Thank you for your you see, the inspiring words and inspiring motivation, I could say, about the overall approach you have taken. Thank you for this. Yes, the price and certain price and certain reduction issues and questions were there. But friends, let me tell you, the market will take care of all the situation. It's not on the real estate developers or the VC user. Market will take care of everything. So with this, I would request Neeraj Harodia, please can you propose a formal vote of thanks for this session and to our panelists and to all our attendees.
Thank you, President sir, for giving this opportunity. So, from on behalf of ACA, we are very much thankful to Mr. Nandu Melani, Mr. Sanjay Jain, Mr. Apurv Salarpuria, Mr. Soumya Patodia for taking participate in this panel discussion on this very important issues. We are also very much thankful to our past president, Mr. Jinesh Vanjara, for moderating this session. And we are thankful to entire ACE team, our president, our secretary, to organize this session. And we are thankful to all our more than 200 participants, professionals, members from CREDAI who have joined today on this discussion. So again, very warm heart of thanks to all of you. And tomorrow again, we have a session on capital market. Mr. S.P. Tulshyan and Mr. Sankar Sharma will be there. So please, I'll request all of you to join tomorrow at 11 a.m. in this panel discussion related to capital market. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you all again. The link for joining will be same as of today, as was used today. So please do join us tomorrow at 11 a.m. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much.